everyone, it's Michael Duggal with Remax Premier. I appreciate you tuning in to watch this short message where I'm going to update you as to what's transpired over the past month. Let's update you about the real estate market here in the greater Toronto area. I'm shooting this on September the 8th, 2019, and we now have all the data from August 2019. So we have all the information about recently sold properties and listings as well. Firstly, if you don't know who I am, my name is Michael Duggal with Remax Premier. I'm in the top 1% of agents in North America. I specialize in residential sales here in the GTA, so I can answer all your questions regarding buying, selling, investing. That's what I'm here for. For those of you who do know who I am, I really, really appreciate your support and continuously sending me referrals and just helping me so much with my business. You guys really are a really important part of my business, so I appreciate that. Let's get into the data. As far as the number of sales is concerned, we've seen an increase of sales over the past year. So comparing August 2019 to August 2018, we can see that in August 2018, sales were only at 6,797. And in August 2019, they were 7,711. This is quite a significant jump. As far as the average price is concerned, and this is encompassing all of the GTA, it's encompassing all styles of homes, meaning detached, semi-detached, townhouses, and condos. They've increased from $765,252 to $792,611, which is a very strong increase. Now, as far as the style of homes, there's really no surprise here. I've talked about this in the past that the less expensive you go, the stronger the market seems to be for sellers. And condo apartments, you can see they're continuing to really increase in value far more than your typical detached house. And that's something which has now been carrying on for about 18 months or so. And otherwise, all this data is very interesting when you're comparing things on a year-by-year basis and comparing August 2018 to August 2019. But what's most surprising is that if we look at things from a month-by-month basis and compare July 2019 to August 2019, the market really seems to have declined. As an illustration, we can see like your average list price to sales price ratio is actually down by 1%. And very often it's now at 98%, meaning let's say if you list a property for $1 million, you would be selling at $980,000. This is surprisingly very low compared to what I've seen in our market over the past several years. Our days on market is up by 2 days. So days on market is essentially how long it takes for a property to sell from the time that you list it. And it's now at 25 days. So to give you some perspective, the average days on market in April 2019 was only 19 days. In July it was 23, and now we're here at 25 days. Sales were down significantly. Although they were at just about 7,700 in August, they were at 8,595 in July. That being said, August typically is a very slow month for sales. Why? People are on vacation, number one. Agents are even on vacation. And secondly, a lot of sellers do take their homes off the market. People just aren't in the mood to buy and sell. But now we're in September. I would really, really recommend if you're somebody that is considering selling, either leave it until next year or list it immediately, because you've essentially got about 60 to 90 days and then we're almost at the end of November, Christmas time comes, people stop buying and people stop even selling their homes. We notice a lot of people take their homes off the market for December and then January and then pop them up in the early spring. So if you are considering selling, you may notice that in your specific part of town, there may not be a lot of signs up, even in condos. Surprisingly, although the average price is up, they're actually not as strong as they were before. And this, I would say, is the biggest surprise here in our market. I made some predictions about 2019 early on this year, and I really, really did think that condos would go up in value, and they are, but we're not seeing bidding wars with the exception of downtown. In downtown Toronto, the market is very, very strong. If you're a seller, don't be surprised if you get multiple offers and you sell within a week. But otherwise, if you're in New York region, it's a little bit more balanced. If you're looking to buy a condo in this market, I would really say it's a good idea to get out there and purchase before, who knows, it could be very, very hot again. This is throughout the whole GTA. I hope all this information was helpful. If you can think of anyone buying, selling, investing, call me. My customers get excellent service. You know how to reach me. My number is 416-671-5218. It's Michael Duggal with RE/MAX Premier. Hey, if you can think of anyone else that may find this information helpful, forward the email to them. If you received this by email or if you just came across it on YouTube, just simply copy and paste the video link. And again, really, really appreciate all your referrals. It's Michael Duggal, and I'll look forward to seeing you all next time.